We will discuss the indoor PCB of the TCL mini split air conditioner. First, we will discuss the electrical connections. Look here, these are its main lines. The main supply is connected to the 4-number pin of the relay connector. The output is connected to pin number 3. When electricity reaches here, it is directly connected to this fuse. It is a 3.15 amp fuse. If for any reason this fuse blows, the PCB will not work. So make sure to check it and keep this in mind. This gray-colored component you see is not a capacitor. It's an MOV or ZNR. This is designed to protect from voltage surges. When exposed to high voltages, ZNR exhibit a significant decrease in resistance, allowing them to absorb and dissipate the excess energy. This causes the fuse we discussed earlier to blow. When the fuse blows, it protects the PCB from damage. So make sure to check this ZNR. If it has some resistance, it is in good condition. If not, it means the ZNR has become faulty. Next, let's look at this capacitor. It is used to control voltage spikes. If any spikes in voltage occur, this capacitor helps to control and absorb them, purifying the signal. Beyond this, you can see a line filter, which suppress electromagnetic interference and improve the quality of power or signal lines by filtering out unwanted noise. After that, there's another capacitor, which is also installed to handle spikes in the system. Moving forward, there is an NTC sensor installed here. Now, there's another capacitor here, but before that, notice that the electric supply passes through the negative terminal of the NTC sensor before entering here. This is the rectifier. It should receive 200 to 230 volts AC, which it converts into DC voltage. Along with the rectifier, there's also a 450 volts, 47 microfarad capacitor. The capacitor on the DC side after rectification is essential for converting the pulsating DC output of a rectifier into a smoother and more stable DC supply. Now, looking at the negative terminal, you can see that all the components are connected here. Notice this part. It's a switching IC, specifically the TNY279PN. This IC plays a key role in the system, and if it fails, the entire system will stop working. So it is very important to ensure that this IC is in good condition. When we look at the switching IC, its pins 5, 6, 7, and 8 are the source pins. Specifically, pin 1 receives the monitor voltages, pin 2 receives the control voltages, pin 3 is the drain pin. Let's dive into how the monitor and control voltages are generated. The capacitor installed here is a 10 microfarad, 50 volts capacitor. If this capacitor fails for any reason and the monitor voltages do not appear, it could cause issues. That's why it is crucial to check the capacitor C13 to ensure it provides 20 volts. If 20 volts is present at this point, then the monitor voltages at pin 1 should also be 20 volts. Likewise, pin 2, control voltage, should also show 20 volts. This ensures that the switching IC will function properly and remain stable. When the switching IC first receives power, it turns the system on for a few milliseconds. After that, it checks the control and monitor voltages. If it doesn't detect the correct voltages within a few seconds, the PCB will not power on. If the correct voltages are detected, the system is considered functioning properly, and the IC will continue to switch the source to the drain. Inside the switching IC, there is an N-channel MOSFET, which switches the source point to the drain point. This process enables the chopper to turn on and the system to work as intended. As we move forward, the chopper pins also start generating electricity. The positive voltage comes from here, but notice the negative point. You can see the capacitors here. These capacitors are used to generate the negative point, which is grounded. Through these capacitors, grounding is established. Now let me explain how the control pin works. Look here, this is the control pin, and it has a resistor connected to it. When 20 volts comes in, it charges the capacitor, and along with the capacitor, there is a 1502 resistor, which is a 15k ohms resistor. This resistor is connected to pin number 2, the control pin. When 20 volts reaches this point, it is reduced through the resistor, bringing the voltage down to around 6 volts. This is how the control voltage is generated. If the voltage increases beyond a certain level, the resistor will allow even higher voltages to pass through, which will inform the pin that the system is not working correctly. In addition to this, there are monitor voltages present as well. This entire setup is designed with safety in mind, ensuring that the PCB is protected from damage. If there is an issue, the IC will blow, but the rest of the system is kept safe to prevent further damage to the PCB. This way, the system is protected in case of any faults. Now, let's discuss how the low voltages are managed. You can see that there is an optocoupler installed here, the black-colored component, labeled IC5. This optocoupler is responsible for generating the feedback. But how does it work? Let's take a closer look. A reference IC has been installed here. When the system is turned on, voltages are generated at various points, and I'll explain where these voltages appear. First, there is a capacitor, E2, which is 25 volts, 1000 microfarads. The voltage on its pin should be 11 volts for the system to function correctly. Once the voltage is stable, voltages are then passed through various resistors and components. For example, capacitor number 7 should receive 7 volts at its pin to ensure that the system continues to work. When the voltage at capacitor 7 is appropriate, the optocoupler generates the necessary feedback. If the voltage here doesn't reach 8 volts, the system will not operate correctly. The reference IC works by monitoring and processing the voltages, and then sending the appropriate signal to the optocoupler. If this reference IC becomes faulty, it will cause problems in the system's operation. Moving forward, there are two fusible resistors installed. These resistors serve as a protective mechanism. If high voltages or low voltages beyond safe limits pass through, these resistors will burn out, thereby protecting the rest of the system. However, if these resistors are functioning correctly, the system will continue operating. After these resistors, there is a voltage regulator, but it is not just a simple regulator. It is a complete voltage regulation circuit. This regulator ensures that 5 volts is delivered to the system. Here's how it works. 12 volts should be present at a specific point in the circuit, the input to the regulator. The regulator will then convert the 12 volts into 5 volts, which is critical for the system's functionality. This regulated 5 volts is essential for the microcontroller to operate properly and for the system to remain stable. If the voltage levels deviate, the system may not function correctly or could face failures. Now let me explain how its fan circuit works. Look, there is an IC installed here, R3BMF5, and this is a triac. The triac is operated for various functions, such as running the fan motor. This fan motor is an AC fan motor. Let me explain how it works. There is a resistance installed here, which is a 150k ohm resistor. The voltage passes through this resistor and reduces before reaching the capacitor. At this point, there should be around 1.5 volts AC. Inside this, there is an emitting diode, which is part of an optocoupler model P620. If 1.5 to 1.8 volts are present here, the optocoupler will function. The electricity passing through it means the zero crossing signal is being detected, which indicates that the system is operational. The electricity required for the fan is present, and this electricity will activate the emitting diode. The diode will send a signal, and the NPN transistor will allow the voltage to pass through, resulting in 3.5 volts. There is a capacitor installed here, capacitor number 67, and at this point, these 3.5 volts will be present. This capacitor will emit these 3.5 volts toward the microcontroller. The microcontroller will detect that the optocoupler is working correctly and that the required electricity is available for the fan. Based on this signal, the microcontroller will turn on the fan. If, for some reason, the optocoupler becomes faulty or does not function correctly due to high voltage and its emitting diode, 1 to 2 points, gets damaged, then the fan motor will not operate. This happens because the zero crossing detection system stops working. Now, let me explain another component installed here. There is a 47 ohm resistor and an inductor. Here, a double safety system has been designed. The direct electricity coming in is passed through the resistor and reaches the capacitor. The capacitor is installed here to control spikes. If any kind of voltage spike occurs, the capacitor will protect the fan motor from damage. Similarly, when the IC, which is the triac IC, turns on and operates correctly, an inductor is also connected alongside it. After this, the electricity flows toward the fan. This means two safety devices have been installed to prevent any issues. If the 47 ohm resistor also becomes faulty, the system will not function properly. Now, let's discuss how the IC turns on. Separate wires are connected for this purpose. You may have noticed the different speed settings: low speed, medium speed, and high speed. Let me explain how these work. The microcontroller sends signals in the form of pulses. Here's how it controls the speed. 1. Low speed. If the fan needs to run at low speed, the microcontroller sends pulses at a slower rate. It turns the IC on and off repeatedly. This on-off cycle controls the lower speed. For medium speed, the microcontroller increases the frequency of the pulses. The IC is turned on and off at a faster rate compared to low speed, which increases the fan's speed. For full speed, the microcontroller keeps the IC completely on without any interruptions. This allows a continuous flow of voltage to the fan motor, making it run at maximum speed. In this way, the microcontroller controls the fan's speed. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.